Henri de Castres, you are the chairman and the chief executive of AXA, which is one of the world's very biggest insurance companies. Thank you for being with WPC TV. You've just been in a session on global governance, and one of the big issues was inequality. How do you see global inequality in the economic sense being resolved to a more acceptable, I use the word in quotes, level?
Well, I mean, it's a huge issue, and I do not pretend to have the answer. When you speak about inequalities, I think you used to have the inequalities between the mature countries and the developing world. They are, I mean, getting smaller with the emergence of this developing world. So this is going in the right direction, and every year hundreds of millions of people are coming out of poverty.
So globalization is...
Well, I think globalization is... Globalization is a key driver of the reduction in inequalities between countries. As long as you have free trade, free capital flows, free flow of talents. Having said that, within the societies, you may have a growing inequality, which is less sustainable if the pie doesn't grow.
Is that inequality within both countries which are both developed and developing, or?
I think it's happening both ways. The in the mature countries, where a lot of restructuring is going on, where whole sectors are disappearing, you may see a fraction of the population left over in a very dire situation. On the other hand, in emerging countries, you may see some people accumulating a phenomenal amount of wealth in a quite opaque way.
And you get to a point where it's socially unsustainable. If you look, for example, at the demonstrations in Brazil over the World Cup, which presumably is the result of an awareness of social economic inequality.
Yes, probably. But I mean, you cannot expect the world, I mean, with its complexity, to grow without friction. So nobody can pretend to have the solution. But I think there are one or two things which can be done. When it comes to an excessive economic accumulation, most of the time it's due to a lack of transparency or to a lack of competition. So increasing the transparency, increasing the competition, is a way to make the markets work better and to avoid these unjustified inequalities. On the other hand, for individuals, I think promoting education with the very powerful tools now which digital is giving us, I mean, e-education is going to be a great way, I think, to give better chances to more people and therefore down the road to reduce inequalities.
And last question, in that context, do you view globalization as a permanent process or something which could be rolled back by protectionism in dire economic times?
I think globalization is like the sea, has been there forever, will be there forever, but there are tides coming up, retreating. Generally speaking, it's, I think, progressing. And it's a good thing for the world.
Henri de Castres, thank you very much for being with us.
Thank you.